गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 11, दिस इज द नेक्स्ट सेगमेंट ऑफ द वेक्टर चैप्टर और रदर से मोशन इन प्लेन दैट इज वन डायमेंशन एंड टू डायमेंशन मोशन चैप्टर. सो वी नो द थ्री डायमेंशन वेक्टर, हाउ विल गेट द रिजोल्यूशन वेक्टर फॉर थ्री डायमेंशन टू डायमेंशन वी हैव डन. नाउ टूडे वी विल गो फॉर दैट पार्ट दैट इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ वेक्टर, एडिशन ऑफ वेक्टर वी हैव डन. अच्छा सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ वेक्टर वी हैड डन. टुडे इज द पार्ट ऑफ डिस्कशन रिगार्डिंग मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ वेक्टर. सो मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ वेक्टर मीन्स इफ देयर आर टू वेक्टर्स, सपोज वन वेक्टर इज वेक्टर ए एंड अनदर वेक्टर इज वेक्टर ए एंड अनदर वेक्टर इज वेक्टर बी. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू डू मल्टीप्लीकेशन इन बिटवीन टू वेक्टर. नाउ सिंस इट इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी मीन्स देयर आर सम डिफरेंट रूल्स टू गेट द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द वेक्टर्स. रिमेम्बर दैट ऑलवेज देयर इज टू टाइप ऑफ वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट, ऑलवेज देयर इज टू टाइप ऑफ रूल्स बाय विच वी कैन डू वेक्टर मल्टीप्लीकेशन. फर्स्ट रूल इज दैट इज वेक्टर स्केलर प्रोडक्ट. रिमेम्बर फर्स्ट रूल इज वेक्टर स्केलर प्रोडक्ट, अनदर रूल इज वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट, स्केलर प्रोडक्ट एंड वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट. रिमेम्बर दैट व्हेन वी परफॉर्म द मल्टीप्लीकेशन, इफ आफ्टर मल्टीप्लीकेशन आई एम गेटिंग अ स्केलर क्वांटिटी, if after multiplication of two vector quantity I am getting one scalar quantity, so that multiplication is called scalar product of vector multiplication. And when I am doing multiplication in between two vector quantity and as a result again I am getting another vector quantity, that is called vector product. Simply scalar product is called dot product, this one is called as dot product. Scalar product is called dot product and vector product is called cross product. So scalar product is called dot product and vector product is called cross product. Why? If I asked you, if I am telling you do multiplication in between vector A and B in terms of scalar multiplication, then what you will do, you will write it like that, A dot B, vector A dot B. Clear? This is scalar product sign or vector product. How we will do the multiplication? According to the formula of scalar product, we know that that is A dot B is equal to magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B cos theta. From where I am getting theta? Suppose one vector is along this direction, this is vector A, another vector is moving along this direction, this is vector B. So this is the angle between these two, this is the angle between these two. Now if I want to multiply these two vector, so what I am doing, A dot B, A dot B. If I do A dot B, then what I am getting according to the formula, that is equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B cos theta, magnitude of B A, magnitude of B cos theta. How? Let's go for that. See, if this is B, clear, this is B, then what is the component of B acting along A? What is the component of B acting along A? We know what? If this is my B vector, then component of B along A is B cos theta. Previous day we had done this. This is called B cos theta. Clear? So, if I do the multiplication, so magnitude of A I am taking, magnitude of B along direction of A, magnitude of B along direction of A will be the component of B will be what? B of cos theta. So if I do the multiplication, from where I want the scalar. From where I want the scalar. So this is the formula you should remember. That is A dot B equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B cos theta. This is called scalar product. Now there are some properties of this scalar product you should know. First of all, the scalar product is always commutative. Means what? You are doing A dot B or B dot A, both will give the same value. Means if I am doing A dot B, that time suppose value is given 5, and if I am doing B dot A, that time also I will get 5. Clear? So the first property is that scalar product is commutative. Means you are performing A dot B or B dot A, both will give you the same result. Next one, scalar product is distributive. Means what? Distributive property means what? A, suppose A dot vector B plus vector C. So I can write A dot B plus A dot C. So vector product, vector scalar product is also distributed. Next property is that scalar product of two mutually perpendicular vector is zero. Means if the angle between two vector theta is 90 degree, then scalar product is zero. Means if someone is asking you ki scalar product of two vector is zero, then what is the angle between them? Then obviously the angle between them is 90 degree. How? Because we know A dot B equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B cos theta. Now if the angle between these two vector is 90 degree, which means here what I can write? Cos of 90 degree. What is the value of cos 90 degree? Zero. Therefore if the angle between two vector is 90 degree or they are mutually perpendicular to each other, then what is happening? The scalar product in between the two vector will give me a zero. Next one, the scalar product of orthogonal vector. What are my orthogonal unit vector? We know I am having three orthogonal unit vector. Those are I cap, j cap, k cap. I cap, j cap, k cap. So means what? Suppose I am drawing over here again. So this one is what? For I cap, clear, x axis. This one is suppose what? K cap for z axis. And this one is what? J cap, I cap, j cap, k cap. So I dot j, I dot j. What is the angle between I and j? Angle between I and j is 90 degree. So I dot j will be 0. I dot j will be 0. J dot k will be 0. K dot i